Hello, everybody. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Halo for the original Xbox. In our last episode, we did Mission 4, The Silent Cartographer, and now it is time to move on to Mission 5, Assault on the Control Room. And as always, we will be playing on normal, so let's get ready to do this. Alright, here we go. Now, first of all, grenade! I don't think I got anybody. No, you don't! Man, I almost got killed right at the very beginning. That would have been absolutely embarrassing. So, yeah, after... Yeah, that's for interrupting me. So, yeah, after Mission 4, where we found the location of Halo's control center, here in Mission 5, we are now going to actually go to it. So, yeah. And just to give everybody a fair warning, this is the longest mission so far. So, get comfortable, because we're going to be here for a while. I won't be surprised if I have to split this into 4 parts. Usually I split the episodes into 3 parts. This might be a 4-parter. So here we go. Oh my god, he saw me. And I still killed him. What was that all about, huh? Thanks for the help. Yeah, I missed him. Whatever. Alright, there's nothing in here but a bunch of grunts after that, so... And a couple jackals, but as long as I avoid getting stuck by plasma grenades, I should be okay. This is like my 4th attempt at recording this. I'm serious, ladies and gentlemen, I'm losing my touch at this game. This is my 4th attempt at recording this mission, because every other time something dumb has happened. Usually some stupid death or whatever, and... You know, it's been kind of a rough recording session tonight. Alright, there's a couple more and they're up above, so... Can I please get a headshot? Stronger than I anticipated. They seem to have the entire region secured. Don't worry, Cortana. It's nothing I can't handle. We'll be fine.
Interesting. The weather patterns here seem natural, not artificial. I wonder if the ring's environment systems are malfunctioning, or if the designers wanted the installation to have inclement weather.
Fireteam Zulu requesting immediate assistance from any UNSC forces. Does anyone copy? Over.
I didn't think there were any human forces left on this part of the
room. Cortana to Fireteam Zulu. I read you. Fireteam Zulu, this is Cortana. Hold position. We're on our way.
Roger that. Make it quick.
Ah, crap. He dodged it. Alright, get behind something and let your shields recharge. As much as I'd like to run in guns blazing like I normally do, I'm gonna try to be careful in this mission. Because we're gonna be facing a lot of opposition. This is the first bridge sequence. There's gonna be another one later in the level with tougher enemies, so... This one isn't so bad, but... You can get overwhelmed by a lot of enemies if you're not careful. Because they will come at you from both the upper and lower levels of the bridge. So you gotta be prepared for anything. And plus, there's a nasty little surprise waiting for you at the end of the bridge. Yeah, take that. Wow, it took 3 shots to kill him. How sad. So yeah, watch who's gonna meet me as soon as I get to the door. He might already be out. Where is he? Aw, man, he moved. I missed again! Well, that was easy. Yeah, try not to let him see you at first. Try to kind of surprise him if you can, because, like I said, once this elite sees you, he's going to come after you, and he's not going to stop until he kills you. And remember, energy swords are one-hit kills. You will die if that thing catches up to you and he hits you with it. But anyway, we survived without much trouble. Let's move on. Catch this! Wow. Wow, that elite got launched by that explosion, and he still survived. Bonus points for being invisible, too. Alright, where did you go? I saw you. Hold on, there's another one I can kill. Sucker, he was looking right at me too. Did he somehow think that I couldn't hit him from that far away? Or was he just being stupid? Probably both. Alright, we got some supplies. Let's stock up. Although I'm probably not going to be using this assault rifle for much longer. Alright, go through here. And we will come to an elevator. Alright. Take me to the ground floor, please. Oh, what? Oh, okay, let's go. Alright. Be very, very quiet. I'm hunting grunts. Ah! Bam! 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 And bam. Have a nice day. Okay, there's an elite on patrol over here. Let me see if I can stick him with a grenade. Right in the manhood. Or whatever an elite would call it. Wow. I just killed all those guys with just grenades. And it was satisfying. There's nowhere to run, Grunt. And don't try begging for mercy, because you're not gonna get any. Okay, so now it's time for us to go outside again. And we have a huge battle going on here between a small group of Marines over there and a bunch of Covenant vehicles. Crap, I couldn't kill that elite. I was trying to kill him before he could get in this thing. This thing is called a ghost. It's a light vehicle that the Covenant use. It's basically a quick attack type vehicle. It's kind of a hit and run thing. It moves very fast and it's very maneuverable. And it has twin plasma cannons mounted on the front of it. Whenever you're using this thing, you want to keep moving at all times. Because a moving target is, well, the hardest target to hit, obviously. There's nothing easier to hit than a sitting duck. And you can't be a sitting duck when dealing with the Covenant tanks like the one that I just destroyed. Those things are deadly if they can shoot. If they can get a shot on you, you're pretty much dead. Those things are called wraiths. They fire massive plasma projectiles that, although they're somewhat slow moving, if they hit you, you're screwed. So anyway, how you guys doing? Okay, let me grab my sniper rifle, because that is my weapon of choice whenever I get the chance. Unless the situation calls for something. Ow, wow. Yeah, what now? There's also a rocket launcher here, which is very tempting, but I don't think I'm going to grab it. And there is a Warthog here. Yeah, I'll take the Warthog. Just to make things interesting, I usually take the Ghost, but just this once, I'll take the Warthog. And I got a Marine in the Ghost. Take care of that thing! Alright. Let's saddle up and ride into hell, boys. Yay! Ooh! Oh, he dodged it. I thought I got him. Oh boy, and there's the human tank called the Scorpion. I would jump in that thing right now, but I'm gonna wait. But I will be using that tank. You pretty much have to if you want to get through this next section alive. At least without taking a very long time.
That's what I'm talking about, are you?
Whoa, look out, Marine. One Warthog versus two Ghosts? I like those odds. Ooh, there goes one. Get the... Oh my gosh, there's three. Oh, wait a minute. Oh wait, one of those Ghosts is mine. A friendly Ghost. I'm not used to... It's been a while since I've seen allies pilot the Ghost, so I thought that was another enemy. But then I realized he wasn't shooting at me, so... Yeah, my bad. Now for the tank! it's time for the heavy stuff. And here is the gameplay help, which explains the controls. The controls are pretty similar to the Warthog. Use the both analog sticks to drive it. And the Scorpion tank has two weapons. It has the main cannon, which is fire with the right trigger, and it also has a machine gun, which is fire with the left trigger. And as you can see at the bottom, Marines can climb aboard the Scorpion and ride them. You can have up to four Marines riding the tank. Which is pretty cool, but the problem is these guys are completely exposed. The only one who really has any protection is the driver. As you can see, the main cannon is very powerful, but it has a recharge period. It has to reload after every shot, which takes about 4 seconds. Marine, you gonna climb in or stand there? Okay, now instead of going that way, we're gonna go here through this tunnel and see if we can flank them. They got a lot of heavy armor in this next section, so we gotta be ready for anything. Let's start the party by taking out that turret. I don't think I got it. Aim a little bit. Whatever, Ghost. I saw that coming. Okay, got him that time.
Enemy mortar tank sighted at my position. It's gonna be a busy day.
All right, let's go. Look out. All right, Wraith versus Scorpion. And the Wraith just killed one of my buddies. Pull back. Another problem is this tank, it's definitely not the quickest vehicle out on the battlefield. If you gotta retreat, just get out and run away. And I missed completely. And try not to fire too close to the tank, because you can accidentally kill your passengers. Plus, there's also what's called a dead zone around the tank, where you cannot get an angle to shoot any enemies if they get close enough. Come on, turret. That's the third time I've missed. Gotcha that time. Ooh, I think that was overkill. Even if that was an elite. And now we got a Banshee. With the fuel rod cannon. Barely missed me. Shouldn't have done that. He should have just stayed up in the air where he had a chance to, like, evade the shot, but no. And normally there's a race tank up here on this ledge, but for some reason he's not there. Okay, I think that takes care of everything outside. Let's move on.